Hi everybody. For those who don't know me, I'm Julia, and today we're actually in my little art studio here. It doesn't sound very fancier than it is, I should say. But today I actually thought I was going to talk to you a bit about landscape painting. Yeah. So for those who don't know, I do quite a lot of painting, especially in watercolor. And for 2017, I decided that I was going to bloom and grow and develop in so many ways that I wouldn't recognize myself from 2016. Yeah, you know, New Year's resolution and all of that. But, so in order to accomplish this, I decided to each month have a project to specialize myself in a specific topic that I really wanted to learn to paint. Or something that I wished I could paint, but that I told myself, there's no way I can do that. And it's been varied. And I do have to say, this has really helped me a lot. I set this up as a way to make both myself as growing and to try new subjects, but also to make it easier for myself to start. I think that is one of my biggest thing, is to come out here and I have all the paints and brushes and paper and all of that, and then actually starting to paint. So and having these projects and having the subjects already sort of made it no excuse. I already knew what I was going to paint, and that has really helped a lot. So the way it worked, or the way I have made it work for me, is that each month I decide on a subject. Now, sometimes I decide like in advance, but mostly I decide like the first of the month, which is pretty unlike me, but that's the way it is. So the first subject were cows. I painted cow breeds. 13. Yep. For no real reason, really. I just wanted to paint cows. Then I painted birds. I still have a little reference here. Actually, it's more of what kind of seeds the different birds like, but I liked it anyway. For March, I painted flowers, and then for April, I painted cows. And it was all pretty straightforward. I mean, I soon got into a routine of it, that each month I started with deciding the subject. I started to do some research. So for the cows and the sheep, I went into different statistics Swedish sites and saw what kind of breeds were most popular or biggest. I took the ones I wanted to paint, and I painted them. That's my radiator, sorry. I'm going to turn it off. Done. So I found out what cow breeds I wanted to do. Then I started to do the research about the different breeds. And I looked at a lot of images, so I made a list. And from that list, I just Googled or Pinterested. Went to Pinterest and found a bunch of images for each of the different breeds. Some is a bit harder and some was lighter to find. For example, I have grown up with Highland cattle here, so I'm pretty familiar with how they're built and how they look. Different, like the blue and no, the Belgian blue was a bit harder to find. I also really wanted to find photos from when they were shown, like on showing, they win prizes and that kind of stuff. But they usually take the photo from the behind of the cow because of the others. So, I mean, I use a lot of references. But what I've done that is I put all the references together for each cow and then sort of build the cow together. And yeah. And then I just drew them all out. And then another day I sat down and colored them. And then, so, I mean, I got into a rhythm of it, and I really like that. I found that I found a routine of it, that I could actually, I mean, painting 13 cows or 10 sheep or 12 birds, I don't know how many I painted actually, but in the end, it wasn't that overwhelming because I had a system in place on how to do it, and it was very manageable. Once I have everything down, I could just put on the paint, and if I was going to put on paint, I can do three at the same time. So that was really it worked really well. But in May, I decided to do landscapes. Yeah. Because there's something like, I have a list of things I want to learn to paint. And landscape is on top of that. I want to be able to paint a landscape where you're like, oh, I know what that is. Or my ultimate goal, of course, is to be so comfortable painting landscapes that I can sit and paint outside when I'm traveling or doing visits or something. And there's a bit different. I mean, there's a few commonalities. I mean, you still need to have a routine of it, just a different one. You need to look at it in a different picture. And when I started to do it, I got so many mind goes, it's not even funny. I was about to psych myself out completely because I had gotten into my head that there is no way I can do that. And if you start to think of it, of course it's true. So I started to keep a journal, and I know how it sounds, but it really worked. So I have a journal, and each time I go in here, or I paint outside, or I'm thinking about it, or I'm watching a YouTube video that's really good, I write it down. Even if it's things that I've heard before or that I know, but if something says and it's resonating with me, I'm writing it down. When I'm sitting here and painting, I write down the steps. So for example, this one, the painting, I wrote everything down that I did on it. And it's not so much for me to go back to and look at it, it's more that I'm actually letting it go out of my head. So it is a big thing, and I feel like the thought of learning how to paint landscape in a month is kind of ridiculous. But it's not the point. The point is for me to actually paint. And that is working. I'm definitely feeling the bend, hence the video. But it's working. And I really just wanted to say that when I started this year, I said I cannot paint cows. Obviously now I can. I can paint them a lot better than I did a year ago. I can paint sheep a lot better than I can a year ago. Am I the best at it? Of course not. I can paint landscapes. Well, okay, maybe not. I'll get back to you in a few weeks. But actually this, in the middle here, that is my first plein air sketch that I did just outside here of our house. And it's not very great, but I had a lot of fun doing it. And that is the point. So anyway, that is what I wanted to say. That is how far I got into landscapes. I still think sky is really hard. I think trees are the hardest ever. I think rocks are annoying. I think branches and grass are a pain in the butt. But it's really fun. And I'm learning and I'm having fun. But I also wanted to say that it is really annoying and messes with my head because I keep telling myself I cannot do this. And about a week ago, having to think, but yeah, I was so ready to quit. I was like beyond it. I was over it. I just wanted to, nothing I did worked out. The paint didn't flow. The branches looked like, or the trees looked like, I don't know what they looked like. It was awful. And I was like, this is no point. I should just scrap whole May. I should just pretend it never happened. But then I was like, okay, why do I feel like this? Well, I'm frustrated. I don't feel like it's anything happening. I think it just goes wrong. So I said, okay, fine. It happens. Just take, this was Friday. So I said, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, just take those off and paint something else. Just as long as you paint. So I painted houses. Actually, I have one here. And for those who don't know, I painted a lot of houses. Like houses from Amsterdam and Poland and that kind of stuff. So I painted a bunch of these. I think this is the sixth one that I painted over the weekend, which is pretty good. And that helped. I mean, I painted something that I felt more comfortable, that I have a routine on, that I liked, that I think it's fun to paint. I mean, the windows are a pain in the butt. I think a lot of things are pain in the butt. But I had a lot of fun, and I felt like, okay, it's not that I don't know how to paint. It's just that I don't have a routine on painting landscapes. Okay. So that is my mind struggles right now. Apparently that and a stuffy nose. Anyway, they are not the best, but I had fun when making them and I definitely learned. And a few things that I have learned so far about painting landscapes for about 2 weeks. Almost three, actually. It is Thursday. It is to sketch it out. I think that was my big mistake in the beginning and why I got so frustrated was the ones that I looked at on YouTube or anything, it felt like they just drew it out of their head. And then I had to sit down and talk to myself, like I always do, and say that, well, they have been painting landscapes for I don't know how long. You have painted landscapes for a week. You can't expect to paint that kind of landscapes with it if you don't sketch it out. So I started to actually look closer at what I was sketching and actually sketched a lot more. And I have found a few really good YouTubers that has helped guiding through. I think that's the beauty with YouTube, that you can find someone who opens their heart and talks about the process or shows you or anything. But I did find, I just have to mention that Stephen Mitchell, The Mind of Watercolor, he is really, really great. And I cannot recommend him enough. I also found Grant Fuller, who's really great. I'm going to link both of them below. He does a lot of watercolor landscapes, and I think he really talks about the process and shows the good stuff. But when I looked at him, he really drew out his scene, and I was like, oh, duh, you need to do that. So I started to do that. And then the importance of darkness, especially on this one right here. In order to make that light green to really pop out, I realized I need to go darker. I mean, if sometimes it's scary, I know that, but when I do houses or animals or anything else, I'm not really afraid of dark. So I don't know why I should be with the landscapes. To get that depth, you really need to add dark. And that was really a breakthrough to make those lights sort of stand out. I really needed to go in with the dark between all of those tiny little leaves. So that was a big thing, like, yeah, you actually, that looks really good. Well, better than it did before anyway. So that's also one thing, that you add dark, really, to add a contrast and the value, and don't shy away from it. And I think the third thing I have learned is that it's fun, actually. I mean, it's fun, and it's supposed to be fun. I mean, nobody's paying me to paint landscapes. I don't have a job depending on it. I actually don't have a job, period, because I'm in school. but I think that when you let go of this, it's supposed to be some form of amazing, super talented. It's just fun, and I'm growing. And when I look at the images I did in the first of the month and doing now, it's a major difference. And that is fun. And that is what I want, really. So I'm not really putting too much pressure on myself. It doesn't mean that I still don't get mind ghosts telling me I can't do it. Definitely. But it's better, and I have a better perspective on it. And that is the meaning of the monthly projects. That was deep, Julia. Really good. Anyway, I just wanted to share that with you. My little journey with landscapes. And I hopefully this is just, I mean, about half the month. So by the end of it, who knows? My goal with this is not to be, to believe that I will be a fabulous landscape artist. I just want to paint landscapes and try to evolve. But my goal over this month was to get a routine on it and also be able to start doing plein air now when the summer is coming. That was my goal. And I think I'm succeeding. I mean, I actually did this on location, even if it was 100 meters away. But yeah, so we have to start small. In the meantime, I will continue to paint other things. I am actually planning on having an open house in my little studio, so I'm preparing for that too. End of the school year is coming up, so I will have reports to write. Not fun, but anyway. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you found some helpful things with this video. I found it very helpful to talk about it anyway. I don't know if you found it helpful to listening to it, but that's a different story. So, until we see you again, or until you... It doesn't really work on video, does it? Anyway, bye.